Today I wanted to show you a GPT-3 script I wrote to hopefully help me become a professional AI photographer, if that ever becomes a title. We're gonna put the script to the test by asking GPT-3 to give us 5 challenging photography jobs that will really test our skills. Then we're gonna use Midjourney to hopefully complete these jobs and get some amazing results. Anyway, let's just get started. So let's just start by having a look at the script. I'm gonna try to explain this as easy as possible. So basically what we want is to get GPT-3 to help us create camera settings for different types of photography jobs. So if we have a look at the prompt here, I wanted to pick a camera settings from the text above to help me photograph. And then we have this topic. So topic here is gonna be replaced by whatever we put in here. So let's say it's a portrait of Kendall Jenner. That means that the topic here is getting replaced by this. And that is also true for every topic we put in here. So how GPT-3 finds these camera settings, if you look at the prompt again, you see this research. So what it does is it goes into this research I have created here that basically has all different types of camera settings. So we have wildlife photography here. It recommends this type of camera, this type of lens, this type of ISO settings and aperture and so on. So we have portrait, we have landscape, we have cityscape and street, product photography. So hopefully this could cover any type of job we are actually, or topic we are actually trying to take a photo of. So I hope that makes sense. It might be a bit easier when we are running the script. So now let's head over to GPT-3 and get some difficult or challenging photograph jobs. So just typing in here, you are the editor for the world's most famous photograph magazine. Give me 5 challenging photograph jobs that will test my skills. So let's click submit and let's see what we get here. Okay, so we have capture a photo of a bird in flight. Get a photo of a celebrity. Okay, so this sounds like challenging jobs. So what we are going to do now is get these jobs into our script. And then we're going to try to create the camera settings we need for each type of job. So let's just get these jobs into our script. Just copy this, paste it into our topic. Second one. Same here, get a photo of a celebrity, this. Okay, so now we have the complete list of jobs. The next we are going to do now is just run the script and see what kind of camera settings we actually will get. So here we are in the terminal. I'm just going to run the script now. It probably goes past pretty quick, but Every setting is going to be saved into a text file, so we can open that. And then we can see it. Now it's already finished, so we can just go over to our text files here, completion, sort by date. So here, let's just have a look at capture, get a photo of a celebrity. So this is the type of prompt it recommends for that. Of course, we have to replace the street photography. And for capturing a bird in flight, it wants the wildlife photography settings. So what I'm gonna do now is just get all of these settings into Midjourney and let's see what kind of results we will get. So here you can see I have prepared all the prompts ready to go for Midjourney. So for the bird, we have a flying colibri, Kendall Jenner walking down the street, a tornado, golf player hitting a stroke. cityscape of New York at night. So I'm just gonna run this in Midjourney now and let's see what we can get back. So we have all the images back, and the first thing we wanted to capture was a photo of a bird in flight. I think this was perfect. So I have given this a thumbs up. So I guess this was passed. I would say so. You can see the prompt down here under the photo. And yeah, that looks good, right? Sure looks like a photo. So first job, down. The second job was to get a photo of a celebrity in a candid moment. I wasn't 100% sure what a candid moment means, but I guess it was. I just put Kendall Jenner walking on the street. We can't really see her face, but it sure looks like... Isn't she like a supermodel? So, and I really like the aperture. You can see the blurry background. And it's... Those are some very tiny legs though, but... Sure looks like a supermodel. So... In my judgment, I think this is a thumbs up. Maybe we should have her face, but... Okay, I kind of like it, so I gave it a thumbs up. Let's check out number three. So the third one was to get a photograph of a natural phenomenon such as a tornado. I get the idea, but does this really look like a tornado? It sure looks more like... I guess the top is okay, but it looks like smoke, doesn't it? So I actually had to give this a thumbs down because... No one would thought that was a tornado. It more looks like a fire or something. But I guess we can check back later sometimes and see if this could improve. Maybe I could have done a better job with the prompt. I just wrote tornado. So, but anyway, this has to be a thumbs down. Here we wanted to capture a photo of a sports player in mid-action. So... as you can see, the sports player I tried to get was a golf player hitting a stroke. I kind of like the image, but it's not good enough, is it? The hands are bad. There's so much weird things going on here. So this has to be a thumbs down. I guess maybe if I worked more on the prompt. But I wanted to keep it simple, so golf player hitting a stroke. I tried a few of these, but nothing was better than this one, so... But this has to be a thumbs down. The final one was to get a photo of a cityscape at night. The prompt I used here was, of course, what was recommended from the Python script. But I wrote cityscape of New York at night. And I would have to say, this looks great, huh? I think so. I think this was the first image I actually got. So I could have probably worked more on it, but... What can I say? Looks pretty much like a cityscape of New York. And it's pretty realistic, so... I will give this a thumbs up every day. So very happy with this one. So I hope you found this interesting. Let me know in the comments below if you did. And if you want to watch more about Midjourney, you should really check out this video where I create an avatar that you can use over and over again in your images. But anyway, thank you for watching and I'll see you again soon.